Okay, now we are going to cover some examples of AABA song form. It is not as common in rock and roll. What I'd like you to do is open the YouTube playlist or the Spotify playlist that I have for this week and scroll down. The first song we're going to look at is an Elvis Presley song called "I Can't Help Falling in Love with You." I'm going to write that down here. I'm just going to write the first few words here. And we want to analyze this similar to the way that we would analyze a verse chorus song. But the difference is you're never going to hear a chorus in this song. You're never going to hear a high, loud, repetitive part of the song. You will hear a hook at the end of the verse. The hook, I can guarantee you, is going to be the name of the song, and that's going to be the point in the song and the title of the song, but it will not be repeated over and over. Let's take a listen. Here we go. So the song starts with an intro. And the verse starts at 8 seconds. So we're listening here as we listen through a song for it to go to a chorus. But this song doesn't. At 37 seconds, it starts over and it goes back to the verse. This is not new. The lyrics are new because it's still telling a story like a verse. But it is not a new section. It is distinguishable. And if we listen at the end of the section right here, we hear the lyrics of the song, or the title of the song. And that is the refrain, that little line there. So we would write refrain like this. Just like that. Okay. Now I just want to back it up here a quick second because after that second verse at 105, we do go to a new place. Now in a chorus song, we might be thinking, "Ah, oh, we're going to a chorus," but if you listen to this, it is not high, loud, or repetitive. It is still fairly quiet and storytelling. This is a bridge. It's a different part of the song. And then at 123, we return to the verse again. And you can almost guess there's going to be, almost always guess there's going to be a refrain at the end of it. And there it is. There's the refrain. The refrain does not stand on its own. It's part of the song. Now, a lot of the times to extend the length of the song, they'll go back to the bridge. And that's exactly what they do there at 152. This is the B section of the song, the contrasting section, and it'll probably come back to another verse refrain. In fact, I can start to write it right now. Why? Because they all do the same thing. 209. Using the letters that we had learned earlier, we would call this an AABA song. It has a second A. B. You'll notice in these older songs, which the style is most common in, that the bridge isn't extremely different than the other sections. In fact, the whole song sounds more similar to itself than the songs that we listen to today, which have a more distinct verse and chorus. That's one of the distinguishing features. Okay, for this next example, we're going to take a look at Frank Sinatra and "The Way You Look Tonight." The AABA format was used primarily in the first part of the 20th century. In the 1960s, especially during the time of the Beatles, we transitioned over to an ABAB or verse chorus format and away from the verse refrain format. The Beatles had a lot of songs in both, and I would actually like to play you a Beatles song, but they keep blocking my videos from YouTube because they have the Beatles on there. You'll see that I do have an example of a Beatles song on here. I'm not sure how this person is allowed to play it, but right here you can take a listen to an example of an AABA song by the Beatles. The other examples I have on here you'll see are older songs, like a jazz song by Ella Fitzgerald, this Elvis Presley song. I'm going to play this Frank Sinatra song for you next. Some country songs are in AABA format. You may want to take a look at this, although the video is a little questionable, but this song is a good example of a country western song in AABA format. The lyrics for the song are right here, and it gives us a pretty big hint that it's going to be AABA because we see the title of the song at the end of each verse right here. Run, two, and this third time. And we can guess this is probably the B section right here. Let's take a listen to the song. Almost always right verse. We know someone's going to start singing.
Someday,
when 15 seconds.
When the world is cold,
we're listening for the refrain.
I will feel a glow just thinking of you.
And there it is. So the song's not going to move to a chorus. It's going to go back and repeat this verse again, another storytelling part of the song.
Yes, you're lovely with your smile.
That's how we can
so
tell right there.
And your cheeks so soft, there is nothing for me but to love you. And the way you look.
There's the refrain. And almost always in this style, it's going to move to a bridge now. It has to do something different. We'd be bored if we heard the same thing again.
With each word, your tenderness grows.
And true to form, this is the bridge.
Tearing my fear apart. And that laugh wrinkles your nose. Touches my foolish heart.
After the bridge, it'll return back to a verse.
Lovely. Never, never change.
More storytelling.
That breathless charm, won't you please arrange it? 'Cause I love you.
Now, what'll usually happen is we'll move to another bridge here. They begin to experiment with that a little bit, and you'll hear it's going to be a solo bridge. And it'll end, though, with the lyrics here that he used at the end of the bridge last time, right here.
And that laugh that wrinkles your nose, it touches my foolish heart.
And here we'll go back to another verse.
Lovely, don't you ever change. Keep that breathless charm. Won't you please arrange it? 'Cause
and the final refrain.
Just the way you look tonight.
If you hear a song from the 20th century, it is either going to be verse chorus, verse refrain like this, or blues. There are very few songs that don't fit into one of those three categories. And in the first half of the century in popular music, verse refrain or AAB was the dominant form. If we were to put the letters by that, it would go AABA, and you'll see they added another BA in this one. Sometimes they get a little creative down here. They could be solos, there could be different ways of singing at the end, but that first four sections, AABA, is fairly sacrosanct, especially in the jazz genre and popular music genre before rock and roll.